I guess, first of all, can you walk us through some of the product changes that have happened at CMHC, just in case people aren't aware?
First thing that came out, so COVID, when COVID hit, Seth, CMHC, and again, you said that it's important to keep up with the current changes in the rules, right, of the game. So the first thing that CMHC did early July 2020 was to limit the use of equity takeout funds, all right? So what they said is that equity takeout funds use is limited to basically building another apartment building, another multifamily property, basically to pay out a construction loan, as well as completing improvements to your apartment building and doing capital repairs. And yeah, so I've got them all. So you're, so let me recap. So in 2020, and this was earth shattering, by the way, I want to tell you this, Seth. So you can use equity takeouts. When you refinance, you take a portion of the equity out of the asset. You can use those funds now specifically for these purposes, buy another one, build another multifamily property, complete CapEx, capital repairs, and securing permanent financing on a construction loan, okay? The reason it was earth-shattering when this new rule came out in the beginning of COVID in 2020 was because a lot of us, including myself, as a business model, and I believe, Seth, you probably use it the same way as well, as a business model, we would take a portion of that equity and pay back shareholders, their initial capital contributions, or if those had been repaid, dividends, right? So that was pretty earth shattering. So you can, the only way you can get around that, you cannot with CMHC, but if you want to use equity takeout funds to pay back investors, you have to go with a conventional financing, which is non-CMHC insured financing, Seth. So that's one of those things here that happened. First big change in rules, if you will, for CMHC. The next one actually was implemented last year. CMHC in the past never required you to get an appraisal for your deals, okay? And that was on purpose. The guidelines were, I've had the guidelines anywhere. I don't have them handy, but CMHC guidelines, it says that CMHC reserves the right to determine the lending value. For the listeners watching, the lending value is the value that the lender will use, whether it's CMHC or a conventional lender, to determine what percentage of that lending value they'll finance, all right? And on purpose, CMHC did not require an appraisal because they did not want to be bound by that appraised value. So I can tell you my days when I was sitting, my butt was still sitting in a cubicle at CMHC, how many investors were frustrated by the fact that CMHC always used to have a lower lending value than market value. Well, since January of last year, so 2021, anything between 5 and 24 units, when you go in the CMHC financing or insured financing route, you need to provide an appraisal. And in talking to lenders like you, I'm in the business, so I talk to lenders, mortgage brokers, CMHC is truly making an effort to use market value as provided in an appraisal now. So I think it works in everybody's favor. So those were some of the big changes as well that occurred since COVID, and it's a good thing. Back in 2017, the federal government, this is the Trudeau government, launched a national housing strategy, right? At $72 billion to create more affordable housing and, of course, thousands of well-paying jobs. This is the lingo that they're using. So basically what that entails is it's a one-time top-up to the Canadian Housing Benefit, a tax-free payment of $500 to an estimated 1.8 million low-income renters struggling with the cost of housing. Okay, and those who are eligible actually are going to be getting their $500 sometime around December 12th, December 12th, 2022. So that's one thing that CMHC has been doing. Another one is called the Housing Accelerator Fund and Rent-to-Own Program. Obviously, the Rent-to-Own Program, you and I don't do rent-to-own stuff, but it's good for people to know this, okay? And the government has gone out to ask put out a call for ideas out there to see how we can alleviate the housing crisis. And Seth, you know as much as I do, and you live in the GTA area, this housing crisis that we are experiencing, they're experiencing it in the States as well, but in Canada, I think it's even more dire, more serious. We're in the right business, you and I, being providing rental accommodations, because it's going to take decades to solve this housing crisis. So in any case, they've got a call out. It's called a housing accelerator. Basically, the goal of this is to remove barriers and help municipalities build more housing more quickly in an ambitious and innovative manner, right? That's all the lingo. So that's basically what we're talking about. I think it's going to be very challenging, Seth, for a federal government to do that and dabble into a jurisdiction's that of the municipalities, right? That's not really the federal government's jurisdiction. So I don't know how they're going to encourage cities to issue permits a lot faster, but that's what they're doing.
Hey, thanks for watching. To watch the full episode, click right here. And to watch another great clip, click right here. And let me know what you think. Leave a comment, hit the like button. It really helps out the channel. And until next time, happy investing.